Nintendo is cracking down in Europe. They appear to be very sick of street dates being broken, and specifically street dates seem to be being broken all over Europe. It's not as big of an issue in the United States. Obviously, we've seen occasional retailers sell a game like a day early, but that's in Europe, it's getting bad. Some people are able to get a hold of games sometimes a week or two early. So Nintendo is deciding to crack down and attempt to fix this issue. This report comes from GamesIndustry.biz, and it says European retailers will now be receiving Nintendo products closer to release date than before. Nintendo confirmed to GamesIndustry.biz, so Nintendo is saying this, that it is consistently reviewing its shopping schedule to ensure release dates across Europe are not broken. A broken street date is when stores start selling products early to get a head start over its competitors. Social media posts around the launch of Super Mario Odyssey did show that some consumers received the game ahead of its official release date, although primarily via online stores, who send out products earlier to guarantee customers get their games on launch day. A prime example of this would be Amazon. In the United States, at least, because I can only speak for the United States, if you order a game on Amazon, they typically will send it out a couple days early so you get it literally the day of launch. Anyways, let's move on. The decision to send products out closer to launch is a potential blow to smaller independent stores who order their stock through distribution. With distributors now only getting stock a few days before release, the window to turn around products is now much tighter, with some having to spend more on next day delivery to ensure customers are not disappointed. It's a bit of a worry, said one prominent UK indie store. Nintendo is doing so well at the moment, and it's been a boost to us in what would have been a difficult year. If I end up getting stock late, then customers will just shop at the supermarket instead. Nintendo has an open distribution system in the UK, which means retailers can order products directly through them, although a minimum order would apply, or via a number of distributors. By contrast, in the UK, PlayStation uses Centrisoft as an official distribution partner, while Xbox utilizes Exertis. Obviously, that part just applies to the UK, but in the whole of Europe, Nintendo's essentially saying, look, we typically send out these games to be housed in a warehouse a week or two before release, but hey, look, a bunch of people are breaking street date. We're tired of street date being broken. We're tired of seeing our games live streamed by fans before they should. We're tired of taking actions against YouTubers because of this. We're tired about all the negativity that surrounds our actions upon people that legally got versions of the game through no fault of their own. They were at a store. The store had it on the shelf, so they bought it. Or they got it through an online retailer, and the online retailer was like, hey, look, we got the product. Let's send it out a week ahead of time. And so it hits on launch date, but they might get it before then. So Nintendo's like, nope, not doing it anymore. We're done with that. Now we're going to make sure that the products land in your stores 2 to 3 days ahead of time, and or at least land at the distributors, and then from there, it's up to you guys to get it out on shelves on time. This obviously could hurt some mom-and-pop shops. That's what they were talking about with the indie stores, because they can't afford necessarily to do next-day delivery on that stuff from distributors, and while distributors can typically get the product there in 2 to 3 days, if it takes 3 days, that means when the store opens the day of release, they might not have the game yet, and it might not appear till later. So it could definitely hurt some of the smaller mom-and-pop shops, but you have to consider Nintendo's position on this. The leaks that tend to happen when it comes to street dates being broken seem to almost exclusively happen in Europe. In the United States, it does happen once in a while. You will see people who will, like, I noticed just this past week that some people got Doom a day before it was due to come out. It arrived at their house before the 8 p.m. delivery date on, like, UPS from Amazon orders. But, I mean, that's not that bad. We're not talking about, like, the day before a game comes out. We're talking 3, 4, 5 a week before a game comes out. Some people are getting it in Europe, and that's the problem. You know, if a fan gets a hold of a game the day before it's due to come out, it's really not that big of a deal. That's the same day reviews are hitting, and there's so much news flooding, you know, the airwaves that day for that particular game that, you know, it's easy to get lost in the crowd. But, yeah, this does need to stop. There was the biggest recent issue I can remember that dealt with this was the Super Mario Odyssey. There was that YouTuber. We did a video on this where Nintendo basically shut down a YouTuber and got them banned on YouTube for 3 months for streaming the whole of Mario Odyssey. And they did this, like, I think it was 4 or 5 days before the game came out. And I talked at the time about how this person, maybe they obtained a legal copy because the game did leak online, although there weren't any working emulators at the time to play it. And as far as we're aware, Switches are not able to be modified as of yet to play those files if you put it on an SD card. So I had wondered, you know, how were they playing this game illegally? And it turns out, based on further research and some confirmations back and forth with a few people, that the person never was playing an illegal copy of the game. What happened was they were at a retailer and they got it early. Now, this person claimed that at the time as well, and I questioned it because it was someone in China. For those who don't know, China doesn't sell Switches yet, and they definitely don't sell Switch games. So I thought it was odd, but it turns out that this person just happened to be out of the country at the time and saw it at another store in Europe, grabbed it, and when they went back, you know, like the next day, flying back to China, they, you know, started streaming it. So it's just Nintendo looked bad in that situation, right? A little bad. First, you could say they looked good because, oh my god, they shut down this guy playing the illegal copies. But then, when it turns out it's just a normal, everyday fan who probably didn't know any better, yeah, that hurts. Nintendo probably should have not gotten them shut down for 3 months. You know, you could see maybe a week or so, maybe 2 weeks, where Nintendo's just kind of sorting out the details of everything. But once you realize what the situation was, this action they're doing now is the appropriate action versus punishing the base consumer who really did nothing wrong but walk into a store and saw, hey, Super Mario Odyssey is on store shelf. Can I buy this? I can. Sweet. So, yeah, it's just a weird twist of events, and I gotta say, I you know, I would stand up here for the little mom and pop in the indie shops out there, but if we're being honest, it's probably the mom and pop indie shops that are leaking these games early in the first place. I mean, as this article notes, there's apparently this big competition in Europe for consumers, and one of the ways to get consumers is to release the games early and break street date. And I mean, you could argue that obviously the most obvious response is don't let those retailers get those games, but it's so rampant and it's happening with so many games. It's not just Nintendo. It's happening with, like, all video games in Europe that Nintendo's like, look, instead of us, you know, trying to figure out which retailer it is every single time, we're just going to make it so it's not possible to do it at all for any retailer. And if that means certain retailers end up not having the games day one, so be it. You kind of lost that privilege. So I kind of applaud Nintendo on this one. I feel like, you know, when games are being street broken a week ahead of time, 2 weeks at times, it's time to do something about it. It's been a consistent issue in Europe. I've been following Nintendo stuff closely for years and years and years, probably a couple decades now online. And sure enough, street dates just keep getting broken in Europe. And as I said, I'm not going to act like it does not happen here in the United States or North America. It just seems like when the street date's broken here, it's either by accident through an online retailer or it's just the day before. And that's not, I'm not saying that that's okay, but it's not as bad as what's been happening in Europe. So the crackdown in Europe needed to occur. You guys let me know what you think about all of this in the comments below, because I'm very curious your guys' thoughts on cracking down like this and making it harder and harder to get a hold of these games. Anyways, folks, I hope you enjoyed this video. And yes, I'm sure someone in the comments below is going to note, oh my gosh, Nate, you really suck at Rocket League. You're right. I probably do suck at Rocket League. You want to know why I probably suck at Rocket League? I've never played Rocket League until the recording I was making for this video. That's right. Right now, what you are seeing on screen is the very first time I have played anything with Rocket League. So I'm probably going to suck, and that's okay. because I'm probably having a good time. I don't know, because at the time of the recording, I haven't actually played Rocket League yet. But I'm pretty sure I'm going to be bad. And I'm pretty sure someone below is going to note how bad I am. But that's all right. It's all about having fun. That's what we always say on this channel. It's not about the skill. It's about how much fun you enjoy doing it. How much fun you enjoy doing it. Does that even make sense? How much fun you have while enjoying it. Anyways, folks, I am Nathaniel Ruffledance from Nintendo Prime. And if you like this video, you know what to do. And if you dislike the video, hit that dislike button. One final note. We hit 29,000 today. 29,000. So my goal was to get 30,000 subscribers before the end of the year. But we hit 29,000 now in the middle of November. And I just want to tell everyone, thank you, thank you, thank you so much for your support. You guys have made everything I do possible. And here we go. Next goal up after 30 is we're aiming for 50. We're skipping right over that 40,000 mark. It's 50,000. We hit 50,000. There's going to be a massive giveaway, the biggest giveaway we've ever done. So let's get there together. Let's have some fun. Folks, I'm just going to catch you in the next one.